I told you not to mess with me, boy. I will whip you like I said. You know, I start talking good stuff then.
Teammates will occasionally get into it with each other as well, and you wanted to make a point early on of making sure nobody messed with you. Two instances, want to get what you recall from each. The first being when the Giants, the year after drafting you, draft a fourth rounder on your team who also happened to be a member of the Bloods gang. Oh. And then the other one being when you decide it's a good idea to take on the biggest guy on your team's Scott Gragg.
Oh, well, thank goodness I won both. If not, it may be a different story we're sitting here talking about. But yeah, I think the first was Chris Maumalanga. Chris Maumalanga, great player. I mean, defensive tackle, big guy. And but he had a penchant for fighting off the field. Literally, I think he knocked out two of our teammates playing video games, over the video games. And it was a off season. And during the off season, at that point in my career, I was quite a few, 3 or 4 years in, if I remember correctly. And he was just picking on me that day. And then he had just finished his first year, he was going to his second year, and I guess he was feeling good about himself. He had a good year. And I just was like, dude, like just shut up. At this point, just shut up. Like trying to be quiet about it, but then he kept going. And then I think I offended him and I said, you know what, why are you even talking to me? You're a rookie. So just shut up, Rook. And we got a room full of guys. So either I got to act like this and I got to say these things after trying to quiet down for a while, or you're not going to be respected. Just not. Because if I were to back down, then I'm going to look like, you know what? Oh, yeah, oh, Strahan. Just challenge him. He's scared. So I had to say, you know what? Shut up, Rook. You're Rook. You shouldn't even be talking right now. You have no right to talk. And he kept going and he kept going. And he's like, you think you can whip me? And I'm like, I'm not saying I can whip you. I'm not even talking about fighting you. But if you start it, we're going to have to go. And now in the back of my head, I'm thinking, oh, Lord, I don't want to fight this guy. And he and I kept going at it, going at it, going at it. Then eventually I'm standing up against the board. And he gets up, and after many times of, well, if you come at me, we're going to have to go. After many times that he stands up, he gets up in my face, and I knew he had a thing about just stealing guys, you know, just bam, hitting him before you knew what was coming. And I'm standing there against the board, and I'm thinking, oh, he's going to swing, here it comes. And he swung, but I was ready, and I ducked, and he swung so hard. This is a 300-something pound guy. He swung, he spun around to where I locked him from behind and picked him up and slammed him on the ground, and then by that time, I'm in control. So that's when you start. I told you not to mess with me, boy. I will whip you like I said. You know, I started talking good stuff then.
Chris was a tough guy, man. Real tough. He played, that's how he was. So him and Mike got into it. We thought everything was with. Next thing you know, bam, they went to action. And next thing you know, Mike won top of him. And, you know, finally, you know, we kind of broke everything up. But Mike won that whole deal. But I didn't think Mike, I'm like, oh, I don't know about this one. This gonna be a good one right here. But you know, that's why I tell people, you don't know how strong this guy is. When this guy played, he probably one of the strongest guys in the NFL.
And the weird thing is, he was never the same player after that.
Really?
Was not the same player. And I think it was a confidence thing. It took his confidence away. And I liked the guy. Had his moments as a player, but you know, I learned you got to stand up for yourself. And Scott Gragg, that was nothing more than just two guys in practice fight. I mean, I love Scott, great guy. I went against him every day in practice, 6'7", 6'8", 320. I mean, the mountain man. And
you said you've looked back and you're like, thankful you didn't kill the guy.
Yeah, I could have killed him. And I look back now and I'm like, oh, that was stupid. But at the time, you don't understand, it's a different switch. It reminds me of when I went to Africa and I look at a lion and a lion has, in its eyes, there's no life, there's no concern for you. I'll eat you right now, I'll kill you. I don't care. You don't matter to me. And when I put on the helmet, that's what happens. I don't care about you. I don't care. You get hurt, hey, you get hurt. Me or you, ain't gonna be me. And that was just the mentality that happens.
One thing about the Scott Graggs, he made a heck of, he blocked Michael down to the ground. I did a real good play. And everybody like, oh, good one, Scott, good one. And Mike came up next play and said, like the Lord say, I give it and I take it away. And from that point on, Mike crushed him every play at practice, like punished this guy. And like, Mike, chill out, man. You already done punished the guy enough, you know?
Scott, I would look at him in the locker room, like, oh my goodness, big guy. But once I put on a uniform, we're on the field, and it's during the spring practice. We just have on helmets. We don't even have on anything else. And Jesse Armstead, him, got into it. Jesse knocked him down, the whole team, like, whoa. So the next play, I'm like, okay, here we go. Scott's gonna try to come at me, even though I had nothing to do with it. We don't have any equipment on. Well, the next play was a slant. He went that way, and I grabbed another linebacker and tossed that guy. Whoa, and I'm thinking, okay, it's over. He's got it out of his system. Well, then the next play comes at me, and I'm kind of bracing for it. So we're struggling, and we're fighting, and I'm like, dude, like, what's your problem? He grabs my face mask, so I grab his face mask, and then we're tussling. And then his helmet comes off, and he still had my face mask. And I'm in that, I don't care about you. I looked at it for a second and thought about it. Why not? Bop! I hit him in the head. And I just remember him, he falls back like that. And then when he falls back, then I jumped on him again.
No, you did.
Yeah, guy had, you have to, you know, it's like MMA, gotta finish him. And so I jumped down and I'm punching, they pull me off. And by that time, Jesse Armstead started fighting somebody over here. Somebody else started fighting somebody over there. And coach called practice off. And we get in the locker room, and Scott had a little blood and everything else, and he looked at me and goes, you got me today. And that was it. We were great. We were back at it. And that's kind of like what sports is. It's a challenge, and sometimes the best man wins. Sometimes it's not always going to be you. I was just fortunate that it was me on those two occasions.